Hallo und herzlich willkommen bei Bau25 TV. Hier mal wieder eine Folge von der ConExpo in Las Vegas. Und was haben wir hinter mir? Ich habe mich beim ersten Anblick etwas gewundert, denn ich habe die Kabine bei dieser Raupe vermisst. Es ist übrigens im Ursprung eine Caterpillar D3. Und das hat aber was auf sich, weil die Raupe fährt komplett autonom. Und was es damit auf sich hat, seht ihr jetzt. Das Thema autonom agierende Maschinen ist ja schon länger in aller Munde, in den Medien, sei es autonom fahrende Rasenmäherroboter oder Staubsaugerroboter, die mal eben durchs Wohnzimmer flink putzen. Und beim Auto ist das natürlich auch ein Thema. Tesla hat ja da zum Beispiel Tesla entsprechend schon ausgerüstet. Google ist dabei, da gibt es viele Ansätze. Hier habe ich die Kollegen von Robo Industries getroffen und die haben diese Raupe, diese Cat D3 quasi konvertiert in eine komplett autonom agierende Raupe. Und neben mir steht Liang Wang, er ist Co-Founder, Gründer und CEO von Robo Industries. Liang, nice to have you on the show.
Thank you for having me.
What's that nice piece of equipment you have here on display?
Yes, definitely. We provide a fully autonomous control that retrofits to existing equipment and converts it into them to smart robots. So the machine can drive, operate by itself, and deliver the maximum productivity, cost saving, and safety.
And how does it work? What kind of technology do you use inside?
Okay, we have a bunch of sensors like RTK GPS, IMUs, 3D LiDARs, 2D LiDARs, millimeter wave radars, ultrasonic, and also the onboard electronic control units. And also we have the built-in state-of-the-art AI technologies like deep machine learnings, convolutional machine learnings to make the machine really intelligent and smart, and he can figure out how to do the job by itself.
So you said artificial intelligence, does it mean it doesn't rely actually on a data model that it has to be programmed before?
We do have some like a data model as a guidelines. Still, we need the operator to define the working parameters, like working boundaries, what is a finished target cutting profile the machine tries to deliver. But from that, machine uses its own intelligence, use terrain data, uses ground information to figure out how to do that in a very efficient manner.
And like in terms of precision, how precise is that machine working actually when you are grading or leveling a landscape?
That's a very good question. Right now we achieve like a 2 centimeter globally, equal to 1 inch globally, and the angle accuracy is about a quarter degree.
The LiDAR system, yeah. Can you explain to our viewers how does it work? What is LiDAR actually?
LiDAR is kind of keep constantly rotating laser scanning device. And right now we have the LiDAR, we have 2 3D LiDARs. One is facing the front, one the other is facing the rear. And they have all the 360 degrees coverage. And the accuracy is just 3 centimeter at the 200 meters range. And have 8 layers for each of them. So we have like 16 layers total scanning. And they can build a map when the machine drive and operate.
Are you right now restricted by any government laws, like in terms of safety, with an autonomous operation?
Yes, that's a very good question. Safety is always a top priority during the operation. That's why we have all the 2D LiDAR, 3D LiDAR, radar, computer vision system to provide maximum safety protection. And referring to the regulations, so far we didn't have seen any kind of strong hammer on it, because in most of the operation, we can have build the operation fence to strict the people access, or we have the people wearing some kind of RFID device so the machine can see it, can know who is crossing. But in case, hey, if there's an animal jumps in, like a dog or cat, or another vehicle just accidentally pass by, the machine will see it and the machine will stop and get away from it.
Now you mentioned to me that there's also coming drones into play in the preparation for a project. How does that work?
Normally we can fly the drone automatically, and the drone will take the image at a certain level, and those image data will be fused with the RTK GPS data to get a very accurate 3D map of the working area. So that in that case, The system will have some initial data so that the machine can compare to the what is the operator defined target, and he use the initial data to create the initial mission. But when the machine do the operations, because there are always some difficult situations, the machine, based on the feedback during the operation, it constantly updates the mission. So the drone provide a 3D model for the field, and we use that as the initial data to start the operation.
So we see one dozer here on display, but is it possible to have like a group of machines working side by side, autonomous?
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what we are working on. This is the first prototype we have. It's only one machine. But in the future, in the real operations, people are looking at multiple machines working simultaneously. In that way, we can achieve the global efficiency. And the next step for us will be working on multiple machine group control, so the machine can collaborate with each other and work side by side or in certain kind of order to achieve the maximum productivity.
Now, what is your long-term strategy? What is your big picture? Are you aiming at being a supplier for this equipment conversions, or what is your...
Yeah, we want to be the technology provider that work for a broad range of machine manufacturers, even before the market or after the market, to help people convert their equipment or have the this feature built in to their new equipment. So that way, the all the contractor, the operator can enjoy the efficiency and the benefit from the AI technologies.
And in your opinion, what makes you stand out from all the rest? Is this, in your opinion, a unique technology by now?
Oh, I won't say unique, but certainly we are kind of a little bit stand forward than the other technologies. Right now, we do have some GPS and the laser-based amazing grading technologies. They're wonderful, but they still need the operator to be present to control the driving, control the motion, and sometimes even control the cutting, because some of the system is designed for the grading purpose. But in our case, we don't need the operator to be present on the machine. The machine controlled by itself, which means one operator right now can monitor, just monitor, not control, multiple machines at the same time. In that way, that reduces a lot of cost, and also that reduces safety concerns. That's why we are kind of stand ahead of the other technologies.
And then last but not least, what is the price tag on such a machine? What is the price for the conversion?
Right now, it's as I said before, it's a prototype, so we don't have exactly pricing model yet, but we will make the price very similar to the GPS and the laser system people have already. So for the customers, they pay the same price, even a little bit slightly less, but they get much more features and capabilities.
Okay, thank you, Lang, for giving us hier all the information. Ja, das war ja ganz interessant, was man da so gehört hat. Mich hat vor allen Dingen die Technik daran fasziniert, die ganzen Sensoriken, die da verbaut sind. Frage an euch, meint ihr, das hat in der Praxis eine Zukunft? Kann das funktionieren? Eure Meinung bitte in die Kommentare unten unter dem Video und bis dann.